the experience. It's amazing. It's, yeah, you're doing a play. It's a benefit production. It's for a great cause. But for me, so much of why I do the show is for the cast and the women and the friends and the connections that you make and the memories. It's definitely not just, we're all actors, and you know, it's not just that connection. It's we're women, and these are stories that could relate to anyone. They relate to us, they relate to our mothers, our sisters, everything.
I'd say that we have really developed a community and a culture of vaginas, if you will.
The nice thing about Vagina Monologues is because it's about vaginas and a lot of normally taboo subjects, is it's and you know, you start right off with that, is it's easy to get close to the girls here because you start off with no boundaries, so
it's almost like a family. Like one of our goals as directors was to create a sense of like sisterhood between the cast, and I think we're achieving it.
You grow closer to these girls, they become like your family, and we're such a huge cast that even now, like a week and a half before the show, I might not know everybody's name, but when I see them, I say hi to them, I know their part, and we're just so supportive. It's really a place where you know every single member of that cast, you can tell anything personal to, and they would be there for you and be great with you.
Everyone's very comfortable with each other, even if some of us don't even know each other's names, but there is a sense of camaraderie because all of us want to be here and be part of this experience. So there is a sense of kind of just, I don't know, everyone working together to create something bigger than us. So
this is like a movement. This is a big feminist love fest, I want to say. They're fucking awesome, and I'm having a lot of fun with them, and I've been making a lot of new friends and getting to know people better, so that's a really cool part of this.
It's just amazing how quickly that everybody gets to know one another. Like after the first weekend of rehearsal, I would see girls from the show out at parties and like run up and tackle them, because it's just like I've never felt like I've gotten so close to people so quickly as in this show.
Kate Durf is possibly one of the most organized people I've ever met, and it's been so great because it really keeps me and our other co-director Liz on the ball, and it's so perfect.
Kate was really great about, like, I had one line that I could not get. I was just saying it, but it made no sense. I was saying it with weird inflections. It was not right. And she sat down with me and just looked at the line, worked with me, wrote on the paper. We were talking through it. She was saying how she would do it, but also letting me say how I was doing it, and we found a balance. And now I like the line, and before it didn't have any meaning to me. It just kind of was part of it.
Well, I'm the one that ended up making the poster for Vagina Monologues, and Kate was the person that was talking me through it constantly because I was ripping my hair out about just being so stressed with trying to get it done by their deadline. And Kate was the one that was like, "It's okay, you're doing." She kept calling me her hero, so that was, she kept me going.
She has energy, she's motivated, and all three of them this year have just really, they're all about the energy and the cast bonding and spending a lot of time together, and I think that that's really good.
I know Kate and I, since we're roommates, we'll get back from rehearsal and probably spend an hour or so of just talking about what we need to do, what could go better, and yeah, we just can't stop talking about it. It's kind of our lives.
Liz DeCass is awesome. She's my roommate for the past 2 years. She's adorable little ball of wonderfulness. She has been another really great influence on me, not just as an actor and a friend, but a director. She helps keep me level. I can be sometimes a little too organized, and she kind of helped me remember the big picture and keep me in line. And she's also just really fun to be around as a friend and as a co-director.
Liz is just like the sweet pie of the director. She's the one who right away will come up to anybody and be like, you don't look as happy as you usually do. Like, let me make you feel better. And I don't know, she just has such a warm, caring, loving quality about her that is just really valuable as a director.
Liz has been really, really positive and you know, really, she's really excited about it. I think she's the most kind of excited, and she has this like excitement and kind of glee on her face when she's directing.
And I see how just motivated and excited she is all the time, which is really good.
We also both are such musical theater nerds, and it's just a really good time.
Sam is great. She is probably the perfect balance between Liz and myself. She's funny and she's got great ideas. We click on a directorial level very well. It's just, Liz can be a little opinionated sometimes, and she has great ideas that help ground us, and she's, I think, the perfect third. It's great.
I think that Sam, this is her senior year. I think she's doing a wonderful job. She has excellent feedback all the time. She really, she gets things moving, she gets things going. It's a good thing.
Sam is such a little firecracker. It's funny because she can be the silliest at times, but then she's also the one that's like, okay, we have a schedule, we need to get this done, like full blog. I don't think anybody in the show makes me laugh as hard as Sam does, because she's just so witty and also just really thoughtful, very good director.
I think the three of them together have done a really incredible job, and I've really felt like I could talk to each of them about a problem I'm having or something I'm nervous about or anything. They've all been really, really helpful.
All three directors are really great. I've been in the show with them for the past few years, so it's really nice to see them step up as directors.
I love all three of the directors. They work together perfectly. They're a really good balance of like fun but strict, and okay, we're going to goof off, but then we have to get down to business. And I think they've done a very good job, but I think they do a really good job of making every girl in the show feel important and feel like they matter, and they made a point to know everybody's name right away, which really just makes everybody feel good about themselves.
I think we've been a really great team as co-directors. I think that the three of us, coming from a background of being in this production in the past and having had a number of very different experiences, has kind of, as actors, these different experiences have definitely shaped the way that we want to direct and the goals we have. And we laugh a lot in our meetings, and then we get back to work. And then we laugh some more after that. So it's definitely a good time.
We were worried about vaginas. The Vagina Monologues has been a huge experience for me. I saw it my freshman year before I transferred here to Clark, and then after that I kind of fell in love with it. I've been an actor for a while, but it was one of those shows I knew I wanted to be a part of, and at first it was because I wanted it just to be a fun theater experience. But then when I joined my sophomore year here at Clark, it was so much more than that. It was personal, theatrical, emotional, mental, every kind of possible good change in my life. Met friends, met roommates, people that I'll be in touch with for a really long time. It's also opened my eyes to a lot of things about my own life as a woman and to the overall story of women that maybe I just hadn't quite thought enough about, and it's been definitely helped make me the person that I am.
It's given me a sense of hope for women and vaginas out there, and I think it's given me a stronger appreciation of my own womanhood.
It really, Vagina Monologues in general, has changed me as an activist. It's made me a lot more open, and because the Vagina Monologues has such an international view and it's such a multifaceted view of the female condition, I guess is the best way to put it, that it's really opened my eyes to a number of issues. And Eve Ensler and her V-Day organization do some really amazing work, and I think that any feminist can really look up to them and definitely be inspired.
I really like that the show puts a global spin on everything, not just what American women are facing.
I think it's definitely given me a little bit more confidence that I can, you know, just between being on stage and meeting all these people, you know, more confidence in myself, and that, you know, I can go out there and just show my personality. So.
So that's been a pretty cool experience, getting to know my feminine side in a way that I appreciate a lot more, and realizing that just because we're all girls doesn't mean that we're all super girly.
Vagina Monologues has taught me so much about being a woman and being proud to be a woman. It's taught me about the sisterhood between other women. I came into college as a feminist, as a proud woman, and being part of the production throughout these past few years has just solidified that even more and given me more reason to be proud of who I am. I think that Eve Ensler's work really brings women together.
I think my big dream for people in the audience to take from the show is to help them appreciate and honor the story and the struggles of women.
I guess my overall goal is that I hope they leave with just a sense of wanting change and of wanting to improve the lives of women and, you know, empower the women in their lives and do what they can to stop violence when they see it.